What's up, everybody? This video is part two, page two from our notes from 924. Again, continuing the discussion on how we can use limits to define the derivative. We're going to be using the limit definition as h goes to zero. The limit is h goes to zero of the function g or f or whatever. In this case, g of c plus h minus g of c. All of that's divided by h. That is the formula. That is our formula for talking about limits. Essentially, what we're asking with an example is what is the derivative of a function? We'll call it 3x squared at x equals 2. Well, it should be a good idea to kind of get a picture of it. Anytime we talk about a function, certainly if it's a polynomial, you need to be graphing it mentally, see it on a computer, get that graph going. The conversation around derivative really centers around other themes that we've talked about, like the tangent line or instantaneous rate of change. Continuing with that notation or that idea, then the limit definition lets us plug in some numbers. We can specifically define c to be 2. We're talking about the derivative at a specific location. We're still going to use this idea of going from 2 out by some small h amount, and then decide how that really impacts what we're trying to determine. So the limit as h goes to 0 of our function. Remember that you need to do the math I left you the dots in class to do of dot, dot, dot. How do you simplify the top expression? That's really not a calculus problem, the simplify the numerator. That's the Algebra 1 content you need to be able to do. After we get it all down to where we don't have a 0 over 0 situation, we plug in a 0, then we can, at that moment, do 3 times 0 plus 12. 12 is the answer. This is the derivative. This is the slope. This is our exact answer for what is the derivative of the function, specifically at like a location like x equals 2. What if we don't want to use a specific location like x equals 2? Wouldn't it be better if we could have some sort of, you know, function that doesn't depend on a specific x? You know, derivatives really are not useful. They're more useful as functions instead of just specific locations or specific numbers defined at x equals 2 or x equals 3 or something else. We want to actually get to like a formula. So stick around for page 3 notes. Remind yourself of our page 3 notes. And certainly, if you have any questions, drop a line. Let me know. Are you ready for more? See you in the next video.